What's good, Love Black Review, everyone? We start back with a reaction video. We got K-pop Junkie, the title already there. It's crazy. Literally, the other day, live streaming on Twitch, we were all playing Kart Rider. And then we got the news that Sunghan has joined Rise again. And everyone was so happy. Everyone in my stream was so gassed. Like, oh my God, it's so amazing. And now I'm here seeing permanently leaves Rise. I did see it on my Twitter feed that he left. I was in shock. I could not believe it. Even went into my Discord to see, like, obviously see what the LLC saying. They were confirming it, basically saying, yeah, he's gone. I don't get it, bro. I don't get it. Like, clearly SM and the group themselves have obviously come to an agreement and said, yes, we want the man back. We want to work with him, or else they wouldn't have brought him back, right? So all these people coming here hating, wanting him removed and whatnot. Bro, if the group is good with them, like good with him coming back, the company is good with him coming back, who the hell are you lot to say, nah, we want him out, get him out of there? Like, that's the only reason why he's left. That's the only reason why this brother's left. All the negative people out here I don't even get it, bro. It's like, in this life, there's no such thing as forgiveness. Forgiveness is not a thing. And if you're religious, you know that forgiveness is one of the first things you need to be doing, bro. So clearly, there's not a lot of religious people out here, because no one out here forgiving for nothing. No one getting forgiveness. My goodness, I even know what the brother's done.
Seoul에서 만나요.
Wow.
Wow.
What's those hands? my God.
Oh no.
Hushy, why are your arms around the eight like that? Why are you two so comfortable? I'm tired of humans, man. I know that sounds, I'm so tired of humans, bro. I swear to you. I'm so tired of humans.
Sunghan just went from being on indefinite hiatus to officially rejoining Rise just to permanently leave the group in a matter of days.
Days, as you guys know, brother, less than 48 hours, man. Don't even say days, bro. Less than 48 hours, he was gone.
Sunghan has been on hiatus since November of last year due to backlash regarding photos and rumors from his private life
before
debut. Earlier this week, 10 months later, we finally got an update from SM stating Sunghan will officially be rejoining the group. SM said they recognized that his past actions were not appropriate for a public figure, that Sunghan admitted to his past mistakes, and after multiple discussions with the staff and the Rise...
See what I'm saying? Multiple discussion with the staff and the Rise members. Brother, everybody has done some bullshit in their past. I'm not saying everyone's perfect, but we all made mistakes, right? There's some things we've done in our past which is like, I'm not really proud of that. I shouldn't have done that. Boom, 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 boom. As little as it is, we're all sinners. Yeah, you, your ass, the one that's trying to get basically got this brother removed, you're a sinner as well. Yeah, we all make mistakes. People grow. Growth is part of life. He was young. He still is hella young. He's going to make more mistakes, right? But again, if a person makes mistake and is not forgiven for the mistake, how can they actually improve? Because they're going to, at some point, you're going to be like, okay, I'm improving myself, but it has no use because people are still going to judge me because of that thing. They're not letting it go. So me growing as an individual and you're still trying to hold me for something I did years ago. But how do we develop? How do we get better? Right?
Members themselves, it was decided that it would be more meaningful if the team's next chapter be carried out as seven members. Seung-han himself will put out a handwritten letter, apologizing to fans and the members, explaining that despite everything, the members still extended their hands and gave him another chance, that he will shoulder this responsibility so that the opportunity does not go to waste. The news of Seung-han's return was met with divisive reactions. While many celebrated it, others were not happy. Many even went to the extent of boycotting RISE, voicing their discontent in various ways. While other fans tried to combat the protest, reports started coming out that a lot of SM employees were also allegedly against him rejoining the group.
Damn.
The uproar on both sides prompted Wonbin to put out a message on Weverse, saying he felt the need to share how the members felt. He explained how much they've talked and contemplated this decision, and that they've always wanted to make fans happy but feel sorry that they couldn't. Following this, in a shocking turn of events, it was then announced today that Seung-han will now permanently leave RISE. According to the statement, it was Seung-han's desire to leave for the sake of the members.
I'm gonna lie to you, I'm gonna keep it a buck. Hate has so much power. Right? Because naturally, positivity is a great thing. But hate has so much power. Like SM could have received 10 to 1 positive to negative, right? 10 to 1. It could have been 10 to 1. But I'm telling you, all they saw was the negative. All that positive feedback, say, yes, we're so happy, boom, boom, boom. That 1 10 to 1 ratio? Shit, it could have even been 100 to 1 ratio. They're only looking at the negative. It's just human nature. It's just human. Even us, like me, someone like me, a reactor. We see all the negative comments, right? You also see the positive ones, but the negative ones somehow stay with you. Same way the devil never sleeps. Chai! Satan's always working. Wow.
Their fans. Seung-han himself would follow up this news with another letter, reiterating that he doesn't want to cause any more hurts or confusion for the fans or for the members. Another controversy that has blown up in the news in the past few days involves Jesse, a fan, and assault. According to reports, an 18-year-old fan claimed that on September 29th, he approached Jesse to ask for a photo while she was with other people. The fan said a male member of this group blocked him and then swore at him in English. Jesse intervened, apologized, and politely declined the photo request. But it doesn't end there, because according to the fan, another man suddenly approached him and assaulted him by hitting him in the face and kicking him. The fan reported that Jesse seemed to be intervening at first, but then retreated and disappeared. The fan's mother would then visit Jesse's company, only to learn that the man was not connected to Jesse, but to a Chinese acquaintance of a producer. 10 days later, after no updates, the victim returned to the police station, who were still not able to identify the assailant. The fan, however, received a message from the producer stating Jesse doesn't know the person who assaulted him and is not involved in the matter.
Yeah, you can see that Jesse was just trying to stop it. At least that's what I'm seeing from the video, right? It seems like Jesse was just trying to break this shit up. Like, yo, stop, guys. Look, the way they that girl's trying to drag that man
matter,
back.
That he shouldn't like, contact calm Jesse down. Or her side to threaten them, even though the victim said he never did. Jesse has also now issued an apology and explained what happened that night. She said that since it was late at night, she declined the photo request twice, which is when the fan was assaulted by someone she had only met that day. She said that the situation escalated so quickly that she was caught off guard and was unable to properly handle it or look after the fan. She feels responsible for her failure to intervene and has contacted the victim's family to help them find and bring the perpetrator to justice. The Gangnam police, who are leading this investigation, have summoned the producer who was with Jesse that night for questioning next week. A police investigation that could end in at least 7 years in prison is the one involving former NCT member Tae-il. In the last video, more details were reportedly revealed that he was being investigated under the suspicion of aggravated quasi-rape, allegedly against an intoxicated woman with two of his acquaintances. With the rumor now that the victim was foreign, many also believe that him and his friends thought they wouldn't face repercussions. Another detail has now come out that has sparked even more outrage. According to another report, Tae-il was apparently booked by police on June 13th following a report from the victim. That means this birthday livestream that he held took place the very next day after being booked. In that livestream, he mentioned that his birthday plans were complicated due to personal issues on top of his leg injury at the time. Another update we have is regarding the NewJeans situation.
Crazy, man.
Specifically with Hani's claim of what is now being described as workplace bullying. If you remember, in that sudden live stream, Hani claimed that the manager of another group instructed the members of that group to ignore her. Now, there's been a dispute back and forth between both parties, whether that actually happened, whether the CCTV footage exists or was deleted, and in the previous video, we mentioned that both Hani and Hybe's chief human resources officer were summoned for the Environment and Labor Committee's parliamentary audit this month to question-
Everything is a mess right now. I don't know what's going on in this world, but there's a lot of- It's just messy right now. It's very messy.
...question them regarding workplace harassment. Well, it looks like Hani has now made her decision, writing to fans that she will be going to the National Assembly for the audit. Hani says that she will be going alone and that she's doing this for herself, the members, and their fans. It also looks like she didn't tell Hybe her decision, as their response to this was, "We will check." Let's stay on Hybe for a bit, Pledis to be more specific, as they've had to deal with dating rumors this week. In the previous video, we talked about the emotional 21 reunion in concert last week, but I guess another thing from that caught people's attention, which was Firmus 9's Jiwon attending the show with TV personality Jun Hyunmoo and also leaving together. The two sat next to Shiny's Key, as you can see by the photos that were posted, but I guess this sparked dating rumors between Jiwon and Hyunmoo to the point where Pledis actually had to put out a statement saying, yes, it's true, the two attended 21's concert together and are simply close friends, not dating. Finally, we have some health updates and or I-
In my world, even if they are dating, what does it matter to you, bro?
Idols we might not be seeing for a while. First of all, the health and safety of 17 and their fans, as it looks like an equipment fire broke out during their concert.
Dang.
The fire was seen on top of the stage among the light fixtures, which started resulting in a lot of smoke. Staff evacuated 17 off the stage, and during the 20-minute delay, someone was able to climb up onto the railings and stop the fire from getting out of hand. Once the fire died out, fans reportedly applauded the staff, and the show was able to continue with nobody getting hurt. And unfortunately, girl group hashtag
I like the fact that they made a joke, made it fun.
Has reportedly disbanded after 7 years, as the five members' contracts have come to an end. Their latest single, Diamond, was released in 2023. Luckily, we also have positive things that we can celebrate in K-pop as well. Comebacks and releases since the last video include BTS Jin's Super Tuna song, Jay Park featuring Chungha, so good to see Billy back with new music with all 7 members again, all of aespa's solo songs that we've been waiting for them to officially release after all the concert fan cams, Cat's Eye Touch now featuring TXT's Yeonjun, XG, and of course Blackpink's Jennie has made her solo return with Mantra. Woo. Music show wins since the last video include QWER taking home their first 3 career music show wins in 1 week on Show Champion, M Countdown, and Music Corps, while VANR took home their first ever career music show win on Music Bank after over 5 years since their debut. By the way, I just uploaded quite a long video a few days ago, so a lot of the other good stuff was already in there, but let's end this video with this week's advice from NMIXX's Lily.
Lily, my crush is in my science class and I want to kiss him. What do I do? Okay, I'll give you some good tips. Okay,
Lily.
I don't know. Here's a cool pickup line.
Oh, no.
If I were to be stranded on Mars, I want to be stranded with you. Tell that to him. And I'm sure...
Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. please don't do that.
You will get the guy. I think it's a guy. I don't know. It might be a girl. Who knows? Good on you. Good luck. Please don't call him a science guy, because that was not... I was just joking, okay? Use me, okay? I can be your wing woman. Use me.
No. No. Stick to the music. Don't be giving no dating tips, please. Oh, my God. Nah, bro. Hey. It's messy right now, man. It's messy. It's very messy right now. This is messy, bro. There's a lot going on. See what happens when BTS are in the army, Monsta X in the army, my alts are in the army. See what goes down, bro. shit gets messy, bro. Oh my god. I can't believe he's left Rise. But the hiatus was also very long, right? It's pretty much been a whole year. It was a whole year. And I feel like when you leave something like that for that long, people get comfortable with this new six. So it's like now going back to what was and people like what is new, it's going to be hard for them to accept. So I can understand that side. But just not if it's simply because they don't want to forgive him, I genuinely don't believe that's fair. I mean, everyone deserves a second chance, right? And that's just me personally. Maybe I'm wrong for believing that everybody deserves a second chance. Obviously, there's certain things in life that, yeah, you just can't come back from. If you know what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying. But when it's like dating rumors or being a bit of a bad boy or doing something naughty-ish, you know, as long as it's not on those, if you know what I'm saying, he should be forgiven. If it's like dating rumors or, you know, he was smoking or those type of things, it's like, yo, come on, mate. You can forgive a brother. He's grown now. He's learned from that. You hope he's learned from that. Let's keep it stepping. But it's a lot going on. New jeans, Jesse, stage on fire. Pipe! It's a lot going on, bro. It's a lot going on. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, hit the like, and I'll catch you in the next one. Love life. Peace.